So this video is going to be all about building LibreOffice 6.4.0. Now I've chosen this one next because I'm running out of space. There's only 11 gig left, so things could be quite tight, and I think LibreOffice is the biggest package that's remaining that I want to install. A few of the other big ones are going to be Firefox and probably Thunderbird. Firefox is a browser, Thunderbird is an email client. I don't think there's any other huge packages as big as these ones, so I do want to install these other office programs, but really I want to get LibreOffice out of the way because it is so big. I don't want to have to start deleting stuff or moving stuff around to make a bit of space. So normally I would have done the basic office programs and then moved on to LibreOffice, but I'll do it this way around just purely because of disk space. It's a little bit tight. So if I bring LibreOffice up, and this is a full suite of, as it says here, fully featured suite of office type programs. So you can see the download itself is 220 megabytes, it's quite big, and there's other downloads which amount to about 300 megabytes maybe. So it is a fairly chunky package. There's lots of dependencies, but I think, yeah, it looks like we've got most of them installed. But I'm going to go through carefully and just double check. To make sure. You can see there's lots of other dependencies that are outside of the BLFS book, so if you use this and you see something you need, then it might be worth actually investigating whether or not they should be installed. It does take a while to compile. You see it's 54 SBU, so on this machine maybe about an hour or so, possibly. It says some small tarballs and zip files will also be downloaded, so you need an internet connection while it's building as well. So I'm going to save these files. So go back to BLFS. Get these files downloaded. While they're downloading, I'll deal with the dependencies. GLM, what's that one? Yep, we've got that. Right, I think we've got everything there then. So unlike the other packages, we assume that you'd not have yet unpackaged a package. This is because the no overwrite dir switch is needed in case you unpack as the root user. Okay, so we've still got to wait for the downloads to complete. Okay, so that's done. Just check the disk space. It says 9 gigabytes required. Should just about be able to do that then, hopefully, considering there's other files to download during the build process. So just check Firefox actually in the notes just to see how big that is. Thunderbird, I'm pretty sure they're the biggest one. Right, Firefox is about 4 gig. Right, Thunderbird is actually 9 gigabytes, so we're going to have to do that after after this one. And it does say the whole set of languages requires up to 25 gigabytes and 3.2 gig installed. Actually, it might be better to do Thunderbird because that's only 145 megabytes installed. Yeah, so I think let's get Thunderbird up next. And do this instead. So cbindgen, Node.js. Let's make sure we haven't got any of the other ones have just loaded up. Thunderbird can use 8 gigabyte plus of RAM when linking. Make sure you have enough adequate swap or RAM before continuing. So I've actually got 8 gigabyte of RAM, so I'm on the limit, and 1 gigabyte of swap, so hopefully that'll be enough and it won't crash. So I'll get this downloading. And while they're actually that's downloading, I think I'll deal with some of these dependencies for LibreOffice. So this needs Rascal. Series scene. That's a Perl module. That's LibreOffice. Node.js. Looks like that's complete. cbindgen. Right, okay. So just under a minute to get this file. Down to 10 gigs, so it's going to be quite tight. Okay, that's done. So let's start by expanding the table. So let's go into the Thunderbird directory. So we're down to 7.2 gig already, so hopefully it's not going to use any more than that. So we need to create this mozconfig file, and let's edit it. to tune how it's installed, we just read the comments. So you adjust that if you want to reduce the number of cores it runs on. If you've installed dbus glib, comment out that line. We've got that. We've got wireless tools. We've got startup notification. We can just check these here. Yep. Got Pulse Audio installed. We've got gconf installed. Let's compile the Mozilla calendar. If we do run out of disk space, then that may be an option to leave disabled. So we've got System SQLite. Yes, we've got all these. The ELF hack causes failed builds on CLang 9 with some C flags, including March Native on Ryzen. It is supposed to improve. So, okay, we'll try it without that. And BLF headers does recommend not changing anything below this line. Okay. So let's save that. Compiling Thunderbird and root, right, I'm not compiling the truth. So let's time this, and it's match, build, and we'll see how this goes. Oh well, that's a good start already with failed. Oh, of course, oh, silly me, forgotten about the dependencies. So let's, what I'm going to do is back up the moz config so I don't have to edit it, and call it moz config Thunderbird. Now I can delete Thunderbird. And install the dependencies. So what options have we got with into the system? I don't know what NPM is. Let's have a look here. Right, it's not actually in that list. So I'll leave that off. And then shared HTTP. Use the system installed library instead of a local copy. HTTP parser. We haven't got... Oh, I see. These are two options. Right, so we can ignore them. So I think we just need to copy that and build it with those options. Okay, so that build is finished. So that was the build, yes. So let's check it now. Check. It says one test is known to fail. That looks like we did get a failure. Yeah, just one test failed, so test DNS. Interesting, it looks like we've got one called test doctoral versions that failed. Interestingly. Strange. So, well, now let's install it. Just run this link command and it's done. So now run this cbind gen. This network collection. Okay, just run this command. it's finished. Let's run cargo test. Test it. This is a couple of fail, but looks like, oh, seven tests. Okay, yeah, we've got seven, so that concurs with the manual. So let's just install this now. And it's done. So I need to mark this one off, 13. So the other one. Which was Node.js 12. Right, can't find that one, so I'll have to call it up again. General libraries, right. Node.js, there it is. Right, let me just check these requirements again. I was thinking about this. This says it needs 9 gig in total, and this says it needs 9 gigs, but this one says it needs 9 gigs, including additional files if downloaded during the build. And up to 3.2 gig installed. That's for the whole set of languages. So that's 9 gig plus a bit extra. And this is 8. So it looks like LibreOffice is the bigger one. So it should be the one I download, do next, actually, after all that. But yeah, it's going to be certainly very tight. I'm down to 9.8 now. So I guess it depends on what these other packages do to that disk space. Right, Rascal needs Raptor. Right, so let's download these and deal with these then first. So it looks like we can add in ICU support with this command here. Looks like it's using it, so let's do make and make check for tests. That's not good. No RSS channel found. All right. So do the... So this is a valid link, I wonder. Or is it just a demo one? Right, that's part of the IANA. Item 05 failed. That's the trouble with running things in parallel. All the messages get jumbled up. Let's try it again. Oh, well, it ran that time, so maybe it's because it was a parallel test, so that's okay. So let's install it now. And tidy up. So it's Raptor 2.015. I've got one called Rascal. Right, let's get my fingers in order. It's better. So I just configure and make, check and make install. Okay, so let's click install. It's done. Rascal. So now we build one called Redland. Again, same as before, just configure, make, check and install. Test it. Sudo make install. And that's done. So now I can build C-Lucene. Okay. From SourceForge. So wait a little while for that to download. Download the patch. Let's look see what server we've been given. It's okay. Okay, is it core? Is it yeah? So scene. So it looks like we just copy and paste the commands to get this installed. Sudo make install. That's done. And that's in general libraries. Now we're going to the Perl directory to build a Perl module. I'm pretty sure we haven't done this one. No, so let's download this. Oh, optional. Let's get this test mock module. Test mock. No, we haven't got that one. Something called super and sub identifier we've got, yep. So I'll move that into here. And build it. It's done. And test mock module. So as before, the Perl modules, just copy and paste. Archive zip. once again, just copy and paste. And that's all the Perl modules done then. So we'll go back here. Now, because I'm so tight on space, I'm going to delete the Thunderbird source package and download it again, because it's 300 meg and that 300 meg might make all the difference. And I'll go back to LibreOffice. Let's see what we've got. We've got 10 gigabytes, so it's a bit of a tight squeeze, but we should be able to do it, hopefully. Right. So we've got to unpack it using this option. I'm going to put the V in there just so I can see what's happening. Now I can cd into the directory, and then it says to create links to the binaries we've already got installed. Save them downloading again. So let's see what we're down to, 8.7. okay. Due to large size of package, you may prefer to install it into ops instead of user. Depending on your choice, replace prefix by user or by ops. LibreOffice 6403. Well, there's a ton of options there. So what I'm actually going to do is to do what we did with KDE. I'm going to install it into LibreOffice and then rename it afterwards. So we need to prepare it for installation. I'm going to do all that bit first. And then copy this huge config command. In fact, if I copy that bit, put it in, it won't run, but I'll be able to edit it. So with vendor equals BLFS. So with language, I just want the NGB, so I'm going to remove the FR, which I presume is for France. So I'm going to stack these like this, make them a bit more readable. Oh, didn't mean to start that off actually. So this is going to all out of bonk. Okay, so with lang equals that. With help, the help without the switcher, help files are not built, so we'll leave that in. With my spell dicts, so that's the dictionaries. Without junit. If you wish to build this driver, replace the switch with a set of switches described below after without Java. Right. So it looks like Is that Jamie's switch disabled test with deprecated? Right, so I don't want to install a deprecated thing. If it's deprecated, it's deprecated for a reason. Without system dictionaries, disable dconf. Can't see that one there. Well, we've got dconf, so I'm tempted to remove that. Didn't mention why it's disabled. Oh, there it is, sorry. Missed that. Disable compiling. Alright, doesn't say whether that's a good or bad thing. So I'm going to remove it because we've got it. Disable ODK. So yeah, we don't need the development. Unlikely to do that unless you are a developer. Enable release build, yes. Python equals system. Okay. That's JDK. So that's obviously because it needs the Java development kit, so we'll leave that as it is. With system, lots of stars. So these are all the libraries we've got installed in system. Hopefully we have got all these. I'm not sure about epoxy, but it does look familiar. So hopefully this will reduce the size of the build because it won't have to build these packages for itself. Surf, don't remember doing that one. Better check that one. Looks like we did do it. Let me check my list, section 17. No, it's not been ticked off, so I'm going to open another tab up. Install this in a separate tab. Build it. Oh, we haven't got the scons command either. That's interesting. Oh, source forge again. Run the following commands as the root user. So that's done. section was that in? 13. Scones. So we can do surf. Make, oh no, it's a scones prefix install. Alright, looks like we can link in the GSS API, so let's do that actually. Do these set commands. Oh, see surf. And then I think it means to add it here. Install it. Yep, that looked like that worked. So that was surf, and that's in chapter 17. So I'm hoping that there won't be any other packages that look like we've been into them and haven't been. So now we've got the system surf, that'll be alright. So that's all the system commands. Now there's some others at the bottom here, I think, with parallel count. So parallelism equals, oh, default is to use all available cores, okay. Don't need that. Disable cups, we've got that, we've got dbus. By default, the ability is connected to files, but I just wish we do not need that feature. Don't know if I need it or not, to be honest. I'll leave it in. Got PostgreSQL, got GStreamer. So we'll add this one in because we've got GTK plus 3 and Qt5 and Plasma all available. Enable LTO, this switch will enable link time optimization, which results in slightly smaller binaries. This is said to make LibreOffice program load faster, possibly run faster. And late call machine 16 gig of memory, difference in compile times are minimal, but the extra 2 gig was used for work files. So I think I'll compile this without the LTO. Without Java. Without fonts. Enable KDE5. Builds with KD Plasma integration of Qt and or KD frameworks not installed in user. The include and library directions must be specified in Qt5 link, Qt5 lib, KD5 link, KD5 lib respectively. Let's just check those. Qt5. Okay, looks like we've got to specify them ourselves. be the include. And the libs there. Okay, so what needs to do at the beginning of this then is I'll just get rid of that again. I'm going to export qt5 inc to equals $qt5dir with the include directory and export qt5 lib to include qt5dir and the lib directory, then export kf5 inc to equal $kf5 prefix. Let's check what that is. That's opt-KF5, so that's okay. And we want the include of that one. And then the same for the lib. KF5 lib. So then we should be able to bring this back and do enable KD5, and with system ICU, we've got that one already. This command uses do not use this option if you have separately installed a patched or newer version of lib freehand, and yet they've put with system ICU in the instructions. Let's look at libfreehand, see if that's worth installing. Okay, we can install that. They've given us instructions how to do it, so let's save that. Let's go back down and where can we download it? Looks like from here, freehand. So let's get the latest version. Go back here to read this. So it says you only need to run autogen for building from Git, which is not. So let's run configure. Let's put normal prefix equals user. Oh, libprevengent needs. Where does it say that? Oh, yes. Right, we'll have to leave that off then. What I might do is chance it. Oops, libfreehand. Because this libfreehand was a couple of years out of date, or say out of date, it's nearly 3 years old, so I'm going to make the assumption, because it says unless you have separately installed a patch or newer version of libfreehand, well, I won't call nearly 3 years new, but it's definitely the most newest version available. So let's go back into LibreOffice. And recall our command, autogen command. and put in the full stop and now run this. Where's the level? Let's install them. Is this the problem we're having before with the autogen? Oh no, it was AC local, wasn't it, I think? Optics or shared AC local. Alright, let's try unsetting AC local and try rerunning this. Yeah, it works now. That's funny, that is. Instructions below allow you to build a package without running any unit test. You press run the unit test, replace make manager, make build. Breaks it. Okay, so it looks like it's probably not a good idea to run the unit test, otherwise it'll just break the build. So we'll just build it. And it says here to build, run make, to view some help, run make help. After build, LibreOffice has finished successfully. You can immediately run LibreOffice using the command. Want to run the smoke test, run that. When KD5 VCL plugin was renamed to KF5. Please update your configuration to use enable KF5 as enable KD5 will be removed after the next major release. So I think what it's complaining about is that we put in enable KD5 and that's obviously out of date now. It should say enable KF5 to refer to the fact that it's KDE frameworks. So that is only a warning, not a showbreaker. So showstopper. So we need to run this command here, as it says, and we'll see how far it gets. I'm half expecting it to break, and I'll be surprised if it does get through to the beginning. Might have to adjust some of these options here that we've used. So here goes. Okay, so that has built successfully, which is good. Good news. So let's install it now. Okay, that's done. Now it seems like the installation I did to LibreOffice might have been a bad idea. It looks like in this lot here they actually do the renaming to the LibreOffice anyway. So what I'm going to do is become the root. And go to the opt and I'm going to move the LibreOffice or rename it rather to what it should have been 6.4.0.3. I'll come back and put in these commands. I'm going to do them one at a time because it's using these prefixes. So I just want to be sure that I'm not going to lose that. Oh, right, okay, I don't need to do that if bit actually. I can just do these because I know the. It's what's that saying? If the LibreOffice prefix is not equal to user, which it isn't. In fact, we should just double check that is set. So you can see it's not equal to LibreOffice. In fact, I should change that as well. Actually, yeah. So I'll rebuild this. Export. Oh, no, it's got the export in the copy bit. Export what it should have been all along. So I should be able to list. Just to make sure it actually is the right pointing the right directory, which it is. So now I'll be able to do these commands. I'll do sudo minus e on each of them. Make sure that lo prefix is carried through. So that's worked. Lo prefix is not on this bit, so it's not really important here. That's okay. Then we've got this bit here. Actually, I wonder if I'm not sure if this will work if I put this in a curly brackets, if that'll work. No, that doesn't work, okay. So I'll have to do each one of these. This should work all as one. I know it's not meant to. Can I put semicolons in? Do that. Semicolon done. See if it works. No, it doesn't like that either. probably what the easiest thing to do. Let me to do this. Source the profile. We haven't got the LO prefix. I also have. It's just a path that changes. Okay. Right, okay, that means I can do the rest of this then. Right, that's all done then. If you have desktop files or utils installed, update desktop database. So that's the MIME allocations. So that means the documents will be open to LibreOffice by default. And that is it. Now in theory, we should be able to go to applications. Oops. Oh yes, it's just updated it. Office, and there they are, all the programs that we've just built. So let's open all of them and check they work. So this is the database application. So by default, it wants to create a new database, so I'm not going to go any further with that. But the other applications we should be able to run okay. So there's a spreadsheet. This is what I've been using to keep a copy of the rebuilds. Let's do help about. So you can see there's information there about it. It's built with 4 CPU threads, as you can see. Linux 5.5. KDE Framework 5, we've got the ENGB language and locale. It's using threads, so it's nice and fast. This release was supplied by BLFS, so it's all goes to show that it was custom built on this machine. If you do this and somebody doubts you've done it, you can show them this and prove that you have actually built this huge application yourself. So that's calc spreadsheet. Let's go to the next one. Office. Next one's like a drawing program. So that's loaded fine. Let's do about on that one. Again, same information. Impress. So this is like a presentation type package. So that seems to work fine. Math, this is just a formula editor. It's quite a good little application if you need to put formulas into documents. So for example, put 4 over 5 here and then divide that by 6 or something, 56 divided by 7 and so on. Let's put a plus in there. Let's do a help about on that one. Again, you can see all the same information. And there's one more, is there? Oh, there's two. This is just a general front end, so you can pick like recent files, templates, and you've got direct access to all the applications here. So it's quite a nice one, maybe to pin on your favourites and then access the programs from there. Rather than, you know, if you access lots of them, rather than having 6 or 7 links. Last of all is the word processor. You can see it looks like the traditional sort of word processor. None of this new modern ribbon stuff, which are a bit strange to say the least, I think. So that is Office. Let's see the disk space we had left. And this is after installing, remember. So it looks like we managed to do it in about 8.5 gigabytes, roughly. Maybe a little bit less, so that's good. Maybe if we'd installed the development kit, it might have been a bit more, or more languages maybe. that might have taken more space up. So that's good we haven't bust that. So all we've got to do now is hope that when we build Thunderbird, that doesn't bust the space. And then I think we should be okay from there to build the remaining packages. So I'll just tidy up. Let's just see how big that was in the end. So 7.8 gigs, so it's a little bit smaller than the rest of it. Like I say, we didn't install everything. They put 9 gig. It's 3.2 gigs, so it could have been maximum about 12, nearly 12 and a half gig. So we're just over half of that. So that's good anyway. So we've got 9.3 gig left for Thunderbird, and that required 8.9, so we should just do that.